Pletrix is a roll-and-write game that makes so much sense. I honestly can't believe we haven't seen it until now. It's got a little bit of Take That in it, and if you're interested at all in roll-and-write games, you really gotta check this game out. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Battlecast. In today's video, I am doing a Kickstarter preview for Pletrix, the roll-and-write game. Now, this is from Truquillis Games, and the game is designed by Javi Hansa, and the art's by Lorena Castillo. The game is for 1 to 6 players. It takes about a half hour to play, and is for ages 10 and up. Now, if you're curious about the gameplay of this, it's pretty straightforward. I think you can imagine what it's like, but you can find the link to that video here. Now, as always, I preview games based on gameplay, components, and fun factor, so let's go ahead and jump into gameplay. Now, to say that there is a similarity between Pletrix and Tetris would be a bit of an understatement, but that association, honestly, is one of its strengths. Right away, I think everyone's brain is wrapping around how to play this game. There are 5 colors of dice, 2 of each color, so there are 10 dice total, and at the start of a round, all the dice are rolled, and then a dice draft commences, and I'll get into that a little bit later. Looking at the player board, there are 5 areas where you can fill in shapes based on their color. Now, the general idea of the game is quite simple. If you place shapes efficiently, you will do well at this game, just like Tetris. But there are some differences. Each of these 5 areas scores their points differently, and I'll go through them now. Starting with area A, the pink area, you get -2 points for each empty square. So filling in everything will net you 50 points. Going over to area B, another simple one, you get a point for each square that you filled in. Also, this will net you 50 points. Now the next areas are where things get a little bit tricky. Starting with area D, the yellow area. This actually is an unconventional scoring area. The points are clearly laid out. You can see them with the 5-star and the 10-star area. So you actually need to get to those squares and fill them out. So this is also about efficient shape placement, but really you want to fill in as few shapes as possible, as few squares, because it's almost like a, you know, like a race. You're having to start in a certain area and reach to get all those points, squares filled in. Now, really quickly, I will just mention, one of the most important rules about this game is where your first shape is placed in each area, and that is indicated by this kind of arrow symbol located here. Your first shape has to go here, and every subsequent shape has to touch another one of your placed shapes. So there can be no free-floating shapes, they all have to kind of touch together. Moving on to area C, the green area. Now this one actually does play exactly like Tetris. You want to imagine your shapes falling from the top. And the goal is to complete as many rows as possible. For each fully completed row, you get 10 points. Now, what this means is that if there are any blanks underneath shapes, they're virtually impossible to fill, though there are some ways to do so. The last area is E, the orange area. And this one's quite simple, but it's a bit unconventional. You need to fill these 2 lines perfectly from left to right, and you get points based on how far you go to the right, having perfectly filled in everything. If there are any gaps, your scoring stops where the gap is. Now that all seems pretty straightforward. Place your shapes, understand how an area scores, but there are some other spicy aspects to this game, and the biggest one, in my opinion, is the powers that you can unlock. Now these powers are located in the top left-hand corner of your player sheet, and I'll kind of go through them now. To unlock one of these powers, you simply have to fill in a square with the associated power in any of the play areas. So for example, looking at area A, if I put a shape that covers in this reroll symbol, I'll then fill out that symbol in my player power area, and I can use it whenever I want. Now starting at the top of the powers, you can see there's a 2 dice symbol. This one is that you can choose the symbols on a pair of dice and use them again. So double efficiency for filling in. The symbol underneath it is similar. Choose 1 symbol on a dice and use it again. The next symbol is the reroll. You can reroll any number of your dice before writing their symbols down on your sheet. And the next 2 symbols are a bit unique. They have to be used right away when you fill them in. And this is fill in any one square and fill in any two squares. You can obviously imagine how powerful these are, especially in regards to area C and area E, where your points will be completely shut out if there are any missing spaces. The last spicy thing about Pletrix is the dice draft that I mentioned earlier. At the beginning of a round, the first player rolls all 10 dice, and from those dice, they are going to choose two colors, that is, four dice total, for them to use. That's right, the first player actually gets to use four shapes. They also get to eliminate one of the remaining dice from that round. So they take two for themselves and eliminate one for everyone else. So there are only two sets of dice left for every other player to choose from. The second player gets to choose from those remaining two sets of dice, and everyone else has to go off the remaining one set of dice. Now, if this seems like the first player has a huge advantage, they do, straight up. The second player has a little bit of an advantage, and everyone else just has to deal with what they have. Now, the first player does change every round, so everyone gets, their kick at the can of being the most powerful player. But it creates a very interesting scenario where you kind of have to work with what you got, and that's why those re-rules are so important. The last aspect that makes Pletrix quite spicy is if you look at area B in the center, there's sort of a translucent square. If at any point you fill that in entirely, you immediately get to place that square in any of the areas on your player sheet, and this can really help kind of trigger a chain reaction combo. The game ends when someone has filled completely three areas on their sheet, it ends immediately, or the game will end when somebody has been unable to place three shapes throughout the game, located up here. If that happens, then the round finishes and the game ends. Now moving on to components. Well, this is a roll and write game, and the components are not very complex. The dice are great. I love the kind of space art theme, and I think that the layout of these boards is excellent. I love how the scoring track is on the sheet, the player powers, totally good. My only complaint is that I wish the A area was a bit more pink and the D area was a bit more yellow. Now moving on to fun factor. Pletrix is one of the most common sense roll and writes I have ever played. It makes perfect sense, and I think it's one of its best strengths. If somebody comes over to your house and you're like, "I've got a Tetris roll and write," they're basically going to understand what this game is about. But then it gets very spicy with the addition of the how each area scores, and also the player powers and the dice drafting. But the core, I mean, it just, again, it makes perfect sense. I also love the player powers because if you place your spaces effectively, you have a decision to make. Do I place my shape for maximum points, or do I place it so that I unlock a player power, which might save me later? Those are very important decisions to make. Additionally, with the dice drafting, you can end games quicker if you keep shafting someone. For example, if somebody had completely filled in the blue area B, and as a person drafting dice, you kept leaving them the blue dice, they would slowly be forced to make errors and end the game faster, which might benefit you if you think you're ahead. There are also some really strong turns. I remember once I rolled the orange dice, and I got two squares on the orange dice. I was able to use a double dice power to essentially put four squares in a row on the E track, and if you look at that place, four squares is like money in the bag. There is turn comboing. The way that you can use powers to unlock more powers and use them, there's no limit to how many you use on your turn. It can really combo things off. If you like roll and write, if you like Tetris, or if you've been looking for a roll and write with a bit of cutthroat in it, Pletrix meets all those things. Again, it just makes sense, and I think that's one of its greatest strengths. Pletrix is coming to Kickstarter soon. Please go ahead and check out that and check out my gameplay video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please consider supporting the channel by liking this video or subscribing to the channel, and especially hitting that bell icon. Feel free to leave comments in the comments section below. I love talking with you guys. Until next video, I'll see you then. Thanks.